are seeing the live picture of the first group of delegates arriving at the delegates corridor. In the middle there, you see Mr. Yang Liwei. Well, he is born in 1965. He's a major general. He is also a military pilot. But more famously, he's an astronaut. He became the first person sent into space by Chinese space program in 2003. And now he's taking questions from journalists. Let's listen in.
Our achievement has strong attention from the world. Can you explain to us what are the major measures in the aerospace development in China? Thank you for your question. Before the 19th CPC National Congress, our airspace laboratory work has completed, and we are building the International Space Station in China, and this marks a new era in the development of China's aerospace program in the past several decades. Because of the efforts of all the professionals in the field, we have developed technologies in the docking and all the equipment of the International Space Station. Despite a lack of launching activities this year, the undertakings in the aerospace field will be continued, and the equipment will be continued to be improved, and our research and development will also continue. New type of launching rockets are being researched and developed. So we face arduous tasks in this field. Manned space activities and exploration concerns the interests of the human beings, and this will be a very important project. We will select the third group of the aeronautic professionals. But this time around, the approach will be different in terms of the number of the astronauts and the duration of the space mission, which used to be 2 to 3 years. This time around, every year we will have 2 to 3 launches, so we will have more astronauts. That's why we will have more astronauts this time around in our selection process. Secondly, the type of astronauts will also have some changes. Astronauts used to be the operators and drivers of the space craft, but this time around we will also select some engineers who will play a very important role in the maintenance of the space program. We will also select space experts. This is a national program, and we have national level laboratories. That's why we have more experts coming on board. This time, we will not only select the professionals from the astronauts, we will also select professionals from the society, for instance, research institutes and universities. The selection process will also cover both males and females. So this new era is an era of renewed hard work, and we welcome all of you who are committed to aerospace program to join our program and contribute to the strength of the aerospace program in China.